In this section, I just want to start having a look at the optical instruments. The first thing we have to consider is just the human eye. And for the human eye, we're going to define a distance called the DN, the near point. DN, and we're going to take that as 25.0 centimeters. Now, that's just an approximation, and that means that's a certain distance from your eye in which you can still bring an image into sharp focus. So if you're reading a newspaper or book at 25 centimeters, bring it closer than that, for each eye, the image will start getting blurred. So that is called the near point. The near point. And the first thing we are going to look at is if we have an object, it's this an object here, and it is at this near point, Dn. And your eye is on this side. There we go, your eye is on this side. Now this is going to make an angle. This will make an angle, the top. If this is on the central axis, that's going to make an angle. Now if I put a thin lens here, well obviously if I bring this closer and closer, if I bring this closer, what is going to happen is this angle increases. And this angle will be a maximum for this height at Dn. But if I put a thin lens here, if I put a thin lens here before my eye, okay, something else is going to happen. Something else is going to happen. If this object, if this object is closer than the focal point of this lens, obviously you're going to get an upright, enlarged virtual image. Virtual image. And that virtual image, if I go to the eye there, that angle is going to be bigger than what this angle was. And this angle we call theta, the complement there. And that gives us the magnification, angular magnification of this lens, and that is going to be this theta prime divided by theta. That is the angular magnification. And there is a derivation that says the following, that this magnification is also going to be dn divided by f. So it's going to be 25 centimeters divided by the focal length if your eye is right by. Now different textbooks give two equations for this. Some say dn over f plus 1 for objects that are close to, placing an object closer to the lens. And then if it is far away from that magnifying lens, if it's further away and there's no specific definition, it is just given as dn over f. So just check what your textbook does. Is it dn over f plus 1 for objects nearer to the lens, or just dn over f near point divided by focal length for lenses, for objects further away from your lens. So just check which equation your textbook gives. Now we know something about the near point. Let's discuss two situations, two problems, so that we can just bring this into a bit of practical, let's use our knowledge in a bit more practical way. What if we have a near-sighted person? What does near-sighted mean? Just what it says, you can only see close by. You can only see things in focus near to the eye. So let's say, for instance, the furthest away that this person can focus is 80 centimeters. So, if we place an object at infinity, now it's not really infinity, this means the value of the distance is just a lot more than the values of the focal length, focal distance of the eye, and of the lens that we're dealing with. Okay, so it's not really infinity, but for practical purposes we put infinity. Now we've got to form an image of this infinitely far object for this person, and he can only focus up to 80 centimeters. So the image that we form, and it's got to be in front of him, so on the same side of the object. In other words, it's got to be a virtual image. The image can't be at the back of his head, he won't be able to see. So the maximum for this will be negative 80 centimeters. then we need to, it's got to be closer than that. So the image has got to form at this 80 centimeters. Up till that point, he can still focus. So we need an upright image. It's got to be virtual. So the only thing that really is going to give this for us is a diverging lens. That's a concave lens or a negative lens. Let's look at that. 1 over infinity is the 0. Plus we're going to have 1 over negative 80 centimeters. It's going to be 1 over f. So what is the focal length of this lens? It's just going to be negative 80 centimeters. Negative 80 centimeters has got to be the focal length of this lens. And what tau is this lens? The diopters of the lens is just 1 over f. But remember, this diopters uses SI units. So it's got to be 0.8, negative 0.8. So that's going to be negative 1 over 0.8. meters, and the diopters then is going to be, I did it before, what did I do, I got, I think, negative 1.3, thereabouts, negative 1.3 diopters. That is the strength of this lens that I'm going to use. Good, now we're going to have a far-sighted person. And say, for instance, they can only perceive things from 75 centimeters and onwards. They're far-sighted, they can see far. Now I place something at 25 centimeters, which is now at the near point, and that will not be in focus for this person. So I place my object at 25 centimeters, but I need to form an image for him, which is virtual and upright, same story, it's got to be in front of him, of at least a negative 75 centimeters, because from that point on he can focus. So what we have now is that S0 is smaller than the absolute value of SI. We need this virtual, and what lens is going to give this for us? Well, it's going to be a converging lens or positive lens. So let's look at this. We're going to have 1 over 25. And then we're going to have minus 1 over 75, that's going to equal 1 over f, 1 over the focal distance. Did I do that? Let's just see. So I got a focal length of plus 37.5, plus 37.5 centimeters, that's the focal length. But once again, if I want to work out the power of this lens, I'm going to use SI units, 1 over f. And my answer was 2.7 diopters. That's the strength of the lens needed for this far-sighted person. Now let's continue just with this magnifying lenses, or just a single lens as an optical instrument. I have a lens with a focal distance of 30 centimeters, and it's a convex lens. And I have a tiny little object of 2x3 centimeters in front of this lens, but it's a projector lens, so there's light coming through the object like a slide through the lens, and it creates a sharp image on a wall 10 meters away. I want to know if this was the size of my little image, my little slide, what is going to be the size of the image there. So it's simple enough, I just need magnification. For magnification, I better have S0, so 1 over S0 plus 1 over SI, which is 1 over 10, is going to equal 1 over, now, I better just look, this is in meters, that's in centimeters, so that's going to be 0.3, and so that gave me an S0, my answer was, S0 was, let's just have a quick look. I don't think I did it. About 0.31 meters. 0.31 meters. Now, all I need is the magnification. It's going to be negative SI, so it's negative 10 meters divided by 0.31, so they're both in meters, and that is, let's see, let's see, that gives me a magnification of about 32 times. Let's just call it 32 times. So because this was a meters, this was a meters, this is without any unit, so I can just multiply this by this, so I'm going to get about 64 centimeters by, and 32 times 3, that's 6, 9, 96 centimeters. Just checking your calculator, that is good. So that is going to be the size of the final image on the wall. Just as a simple problem, if I have a lens and a film, and I note if I take a photo of the landscape, which is very far away, I need to place my image, my film, 8 centimeters from the lens. So what does that tell me? It tells me that S0 I can take as infinity, and my SI I'm taking as, my SI I'm taking as, it needs to be 8 centimeters away. The lens and the film is 8 centimeters away, and I get this. So what can I work out from this? I can work out what the focal distance is. So there's going to be 1 over infinity, which is 0. 1 divided by 8 is going to be 1 over f, and my focal distance then is going to be 8. My focal distance is 8 centimeters. Now at us, if I now put an image 72 centimeters in front of the lens, so my S0 is now going to be 72 centimeters, what adjustment must I make as far as my lens and my photographic plate is concerned? Well, that's going to be very easy. 1 over 72 plus 1 over SI, and that SI is going to be a real inverted image on the film itself. It's got to be 1 over the focal distance, which I've just worked out to be 1 over 8. And that will give me an SI of, I think, 9, where did I get 9? Somewhere around there, about 9 centimeters. So I need to increase about 9 centimeters. I should increase the distance between the film and the lens by increase it by 1 centimeter.